Joe Metheny, born 1955, was one of six children within the Metheny family. At age six, Joe's father was killed in a car accident in West Virginia. As a result of Joe's father passing away, the family was left to fend for themselves, and with six hungry mouths to feed, Joe's mother would work long hours in multiple jobs just to make ends meet. Joe's mother worked as a waitress, barmaid, canteen truck driver, and wished to have been with her children if it weren't for the financial pressures she and her children now faced. And although times were difficult, Joe's mother maintained that her children had a regular life due to her sacrifices and hard work. Joe, however, describes his childhood differently. According to Joe, much of his childhood was made up of what he described as traumatic and neglectful events. Joe also stated that because of the neglect he faced as a child, he was eventually shuffled through various foster homes and the welfare system. Joe's mother disputed these claims and remained steadfast in her conviction that her children had a normal life. Joe's mother, in one interview, even stated that she recalled that Joe was a regular student at school, that he loved to ride his bicycle, that he was very hesitant to get into altercations as a child, and was always polite to everybody. In 1973, upon Joe's 18th birthday, Joe, now a young man, decided to join the army. Joe was stationed within Germany, where he would lose contact with his mother for 10 years. Soon after this German expedition, Joe was shipped off to a Vietnam War artillery unit, where he claims that he obtained an addiction for heroin. Up until this point, Joe's criminal record consisted of fairly light charges. Charges pertaining to common assault, drunken disorderly conduct, and barroom fights made up all of Joe's run-ins with the law up until that point. But it was what happened next that would have Joe Metheny's criminal record take a much darker turn. Soon after Joe's Vietnam service, Joe returned and met a woman who was soon to be the mother of his child. Joe's partner also had a drug addiction, which made for a tumultuous relationship between the couple. But with a six-year-old son now under Joe's wing, Joe would work steadily to provide for his family as a truck driver. In July of 1994, though, this would all change. One day, during the month of July, Joe was asked to work overtime by his boss, and as a result, he headed home late that night. Joe made his way home, as he did every other night, but upon flicking the light on into his house, he was stunned to find that his partner and six-year-old son, they were missing. It wasn't soon after this event that Joe discovered that his partner had taken herself and their son to live with a man across town. This man was known to Joe, and the result of this new relationship would see Joe's now ex-partner regularly prostituting herself and selling drugs on behalf of the new man in her life. Soon after this, Joe's ex-partner and new boyfriend, they were busted, and social services took Joe's son away from the family. Joe attempted to gain custody of his son, but courts would ultimately see to it that Joe's request was refused. As a result of everything that had happened, Joe became furious at his ex-partner and her new boyfriend. So much so, in fact, that Joe had determined that he was going to kill them. Joe soon discovered that his ex and new boyfriend had been attending a location under a bridge on a regular basis in order to get high. Joe attended the location hoping to find his ex and her new partner in order to kill them. However, when Joe attended the location, Joe's ex and partner were nowhere to be seen. Enraged and frustrated, Joe eventually located two homeless individuals that he knew had gotten high with his ex. Joe then proceeded to kill the homeless men and cut them into pieces with an axe. Now with a taste for blood, that same night, Joe would claim three other victims. The first was a woman who Joe described as a crack whore. Joe was able to seduce the woman under the same bridge by providing her with illicit drugs. Joe's plan was to obtain information from the woman about the whereabouts of his ex and her new partner. After Joe had interrogated the now high woman for some time, no information on the whereabouts of his ex was forthcoming. As a result of the woman's inability to provide further information, Joe beat and raped the woman before killing her in cold blood. After placing the body of the first woman in some nearby bushes, on the same night, Joe would repeat this process with another final woman at the same location. And now, with two bodies to dispose of, Joe had attempted to throw the second woman's now lifeless body into the same bush that he had placed the first victim. As Joe was completing his morbid task though, an older gentleman who had been fishing in a nearby river had spotted Joe with the final body. Joe did not hesitate to take action, and he found a steel bar nearby. He immediately went after the man, striking the man, and, according to Joe, laid his head wide open. Now, with five bodies to dispose of, Joe cleaned up the crime scene by placing three of the bodies into the river and the two homeless men in an unknown location. 2.5 weeks later, Joe was arrested after the bodies of the two men he had chopped up with an axe were located. Joe spent 18 months behind bars in Baltimore City Jail, but was released due to a lack of evidence in incriminating Joe with the killings. Joe, now a free man, proceeded to return to a factory job where he would eventually reside in a trailer located on the premises. The trailer was located at the end of an isolated road, a perfect location for what Joe had in store next. Joe proceeded to lure two more female victims with drug addictions into his trailer. Joe, not satisfied anymore with just killing another person, butchered and cut up these women into pieces, after which he placed the fresh meat of his victims into Tupperware containers. Joe stored these containers in a freezer for a sinister plan that he was soon to implement. After burying the bodies of his latest victims in a wooded area behind his new home, Joe went on to open a beef stand for local residents and colleagues. Unknown to those who consumed the sandwiches though, Joe had mixed in what he called special meat. Joe had used the meat of his victims in the sandwiches that others had purchased and eaten. Joe also exclaimed in one interview that the human body, it tastes very similar to pork, insinuating that it was not just his customers that had consumed the special meat. Joe also explained in his disclosing interview that soon he had run out of his special meat, and so he decided to restock his supply by luring another female victim into his trailer. Except, on this occasion, Joe had been careless, turning for a brief moment away from his victim after confessing to his murders, which resulted in the woman slipping away and contacting police about the incident. The authorities were soon at the location of Joe's trailer, after which Joe was arrested on the scene and multiple bodies were located buried in the woods behind the premises. Unfortunately for authorities though, the remains of Joe's victims were cut up and buried in multiple holes. Joe was convicted for two of the murders and was soon placed on death row for the atrocities he had committed. However, this was overturned on July of 2004. Joe is currently serving life imprisonment for his two convictions in Baltimore prison, and although Joe's lawyers insisted that Joe had remorse for what he had done, Joe disclosed in his interviews that his murderous rampage started out as revenge, but ended up as a passion for the taste of blood and the overwhelming sense of power one gets for taking the life of another. These terrifying words would suggest that Joe has developed a sadistic pleasure for harming others. But perhaps the most chilling words to come out of Joe Metheny's mouth was the warning he shared during an interview where he stated, "So the next time you're riding down the road and you happen to see an open pit beef stand that you've never seen before, make sure you think about this story before you take a bite of that sandwich. Sometimes you never know who you may be eating." G'day mates, it's B-Buster here. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video guys. And I guess with all this talk about cannibalism, you could say that the woman who got away only merrily escaped. I know, this joke's in really bad taste. I'm gonna be eating my words later, aren't I? Oh man, I'm so bad at this. I just realized I'm terrible at puns. I'm so terrible that I make them funny. That's what you guys... You guys are not laughing with me. You guys are laughing at me, aren't you? Anyway, as always, guys, it would be awesome if you could like, share, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for updates throughout the week. You can also catch me on my second channel, all of which have links in the description below. Thanks again for always tuning in, guys, for all the love and support, and I'll see you, mates, in the next one.